In a half-hour address broadcasted on Sunday, Ghanaian President Nana Akufo-Addo addressed the nation to explain the raft measures his government will be taking to see its way out of financial turmoil, including measures to support domestic production. Among these measures, Nana Akufo-Addo announced a 30% cut in budgeted discretionary expenditures and salaries of the president, vice president, ministers, deputy ministers, and political office holders. The rise of the COVID-19 pandemic ushered in an era of disillusionment. Growth slowed and money borrowed in the markets became increasingly high in price. These difficulties were exacerbated by the impact of the Russian-Ukrainian conflict on food and energy prices worldwide. Inflation in the country is rising to over 37%, while the currency is depreciating at an 4-cent pace. Since the beginning of the year, the cedi has lost 40% against the dollar. Dozens of demonstrators on foot and in motorcycles went around churches to call for a big demonstration on Sunday against the Rwandan invasion, expressing their positive feelings regarding the expulsion of Vincent Karega, Rwanda's ambassador to the DRC, after months of tension and accusations of support for the M23 movement. Some demonstrators went as far as affirming their support for the Congolese army in the face of the rebellion by asking that they be given weapons so that they can fight against Rwanda. The African Union has called for an immediate ceasefire in the Eastern Democratic Republic of Congo, where the M23 rebels are continuing their offensive against the Congolese army and are now a few dozen kilometers from Goma, capital of North Kivu. The African Union, which says it's extremely concerned by the deteriorating security situation in the eastern DRC, calls on all parties to establish an immediate ceasefire to respect international law, the safety of civilians, and the stability of the borders of all countries in the region.